kalte oe ya ailan oe layu yea karayu fitr. And Will or Rich, if you're listening to this, don't kill me for my pronunciation. Anyway, my name is Scout, and today I will be showing you, in production and in association with learnnaviva.org, how to do the Navi Nose. And this is going to be a photo manipulation, and I'll be using Photoshop CS4. Let's get to it. This is a photo of our good friend Taronyu. You might know his real name. His name is Richard. This is the base photo I work with. It's a pretty big resolution, and that is always very helpful, even if you're going to ultimately use it for something that's form avatar sized. But this is Richard before, and I quickly took off his glasses because that would get in the way of the bridge of the nose. Anyway, so start out with a photo. And I like to do all the photo manipulation prior to adding the blue, because the coloring is a completely different part of it. Now, if you haven't already, you should definitely read my topics on the avatar nose, and also the topic on avatar and Navi proportions. Both are in the fan art section at learnnavi.org forums, and are both incredibly helpful towards understanding the topology of the Navi face. Anyway, so we got Richard here, and we're going to make him into an avatar. Now, this is my first video tutorial ever, so I hope you'll bear with me if I stutter or stumble over my words or am not explaining things perfectly. I'm going to move my layers into view. All right, so here are my layers, and I've got a pretty small space to work with, so I'm not going to ultimately show you too much. So the first thing I like to do before I do anything to the nose is set the eyes right, because the eyes are really one of the most important parts about avataring, what avatarizing oneself. So I'm going to take the lasso. So I use the polygonal lasso with the best, and I'll select the big area of the eye. So you want to select an area roughly this size. Basically, you want to get all the critical information towards understanding, you know, what a person looks like. So, again, I'll go back, use my polygonal lasso tool to select that area, and I'll copy and paste it into a new layer. This can be done by selecting the area and hitting Control-J. Actually, Control-J. So you've got this separate eye in another layer, and what you're going to do then is you're going to, first off, line it up with the edge of the mouth. Now, his mouth is pulled stupidly apart, so we're going to have to estimate that his edge is roughly right about there. And that is going to trail upwards along his face like that. So we want his tear duct to line up with that line there. So roughly right there. Cool. So we will scale by using a Command-T for free transform. And we'll move that up and outward until, grabbing the top corner, until that tear duct is roughly there. And it doesn't hurt to go a little bit overboard with this, particularly if the person's got a wide nose. I've noticed while looking through the movie that the wide noses were really used with people who have, the wide bridge, rather, is used for people who have wide noses. So I'll get into that later in part four. Anyway, for today, we're just going to scale up. So we scaled up the face on that side, and we're going to have to do it for the other side. Now, you want to be careful because you can easily make these eyes too large. And the Navi eye is roughly 1.3, about 30 to 40% larger than a human eye. And you got to kind of look at the face and ask yourself how big the eye is and compared to the rest of the face. Richard's eye here is, it's medium size. So I'd say somewhere like a 35% increase. And to do that, I like to kind of eyeball it. But if you want to be really anal about it, you could probably do something like this. And, find the edge, and that's roughly just over 35%. So that should be fine. The other eye is a little bit different, because it's at a different angle, so it can't exactly be the same exact size. But you know what? That's pretty close too. We line up our tear ducts. We're then going to turn our eyes, because the Navi eyes are about 14 degrees upward using the tear duct, and make sure to grab this little thing to set the pivot point in the tear duct, and you're going to move it about 13 or 14 degrees. Things are looking good. I'm going to space the eye just a little bit further away. Now this looks pretty awful to some degree. What we're then going to do is we're going to go into the eraser. I collapse the eyes into one layer so I can edit them at once. I will just use a fuzzy brush, something like this, something like that, to erase away the edges, which will make it a little less of an eyesore and help for blending when it comes time to do what's next, which is to take the eye, cut it in half with your selection, and you're going to do free transform again. And then you're going to use the warp tool. It's under edit, transform, and then you're going to select warp. And the warp tool is particularly cool because you can scale and change images, or you know, change your selection based off of a grid. So what that means is that you can keep all the information of the eye there without having to sacrifice the proportional differences or something like that. I don't know. It just works. So what I'll do is I'll take this and scooch in the sides. I want to make sure to keep the eye as intact as possible, because the eyes are really, really critical to maintaining the look of whoever you're avatarizing. It doesn't hurt to be a little bit, say, loose when it comes to adding to the side. We can paint a lot of the stuff away later. So again, I will select the other side and do the same. Bring it in. If you're splitting something like that, it's probably a good idea to maintain this line without adjusting it too much. You really only want to edit the stuff around it. He looks kind of ghastly. Right now we're kind of being a little bit screwed up by the headphones, but we'll edit those out in a bit. So now that we've more or less scaled the eye to the way we want it to, actually I'm gonna go in and fix that eye a little bit more, because I'm not 100% on it. Also, a good idea is to keep a layer of just the regular face, so you can kind of switch back and forth between the two and make sure that you're keeping things more or less the same. Now, what's weird here is that the tear duct should actually be more or less in the same spot, so I'm going to have to move my eyes downward a little bit to match the old eyes. They're just moved apart and tilted upward. Yeah. That is about right. I might bring it down just a little bit more. Okay, good. It's a little bit better, because we want to preserve a little bit of that forehead information without losing it entirely. So, you know, I race around, lose some of the stuff. You might notice that in using this technique, you sort of blur the lines a little bit, and or not the lines, but all the grain, the fine pores that are really close in here. And honestly, you're not going to worry too much about that, because a lot of those textures and effects can be added later to fake the sort of the texture and the photo graininess, and I'll show you how to do that later. For now though, we're going to ignore it. And then what we're going to do is we're going to use everybody's favorite tool, apparently, which is the liquify tool. And actually, you know, the more I look at this, the more I kind of want to go in and change a couple things. Again, use very sparingly this little technique that I'm doing here, which is to make the eyes a little bit opener. And, you know, don't use the next tool, which is the liquify tool, too much. And you can do several things. You can keep the nose in a separate layer, or you can select everything like I'd like to do. Control-Shift. Control-Shift-Copy. Oops.